The LA boys are back and they have a lot to battle this season on Million Dollar Listing. Demanding clients, natural disasters, and not to mention a familiar East Coast face infiltrating the California real estate market. Take a look.
The LA market is shifting and it's not falling, it's stabilizing. And that's a good thing because everybody knows, like, I like money.
And Josh Flagg joins us now. Welcome, Josh. Good to see you. I know that the season was shot months ago before this pandemic ever happened. And for us on the East Coast, it really crippled the real estate market. What's happening on the West Coast?
You know what, surprisingly, I mean, I think it's crippled all markets, but LA, I'm not just saying this because I'm an LA broker. I'm really actually surprised. It hasn't crippled it. Like,
really?
I mean, look, it's not what it was, but I do think that people are still buying. I mean, we have some very big sales occurring right now. It's not like New York, but New York was also crippled before this happened.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. You know, in this season, we also see you kind of deal with the California wildfires. Being a born and bred Beverly Hills guy, how hard is that for you to watch California go up in flames like that?
I mean, this is not the first time it's happened.
Right.
It happened also, actually in Bel Air, it happened in, like, I think 1963. So we've already had this a couple times, and then we're always having fires in Malibu, but I mean, it's terrible.
Yeah, terrible. Well, there's always a lot of eye candy, a lot of real estate eye candy on the show. Any properties that you're really excited about this season?
This season, Josh Altman and I work on some things together. James Harris and I work on some things together. We have drama every season, but I think that this year, I really do think this is going to be the best season we've had. I say that every year. It just gets better every year or so.
Yeah, but you and Josh Altman, let's get back to that for a second, because you guys used to be like arch nemesises, you know? I mean, is that still true? Is it made up for the camera? Have you guys, you know, made up? What's happening?
We're actually very similar, believe it or not, and that's probably why we always butt heads. But I think people will like us this season. Together.
Well, we also have another familiar face in the season this year. I know that Frederick relocated from New York to LA. You all are very strong personalities, you know, and Frederick is another strong personality. So he must be butting heads with someone. Who is he butting heads with the most? And I love Frederick.
Butting heads probably with Josh Altman, from what I see. But I mean, you know, my husband and I are friends with Frederick and his husband, so we have no beef.
Yeah, that's good.
I don't know about the Brits. I think I really don't know. I'm sure they're fine. Yeah, I think it's going to be probably Altman.
I feel like LA and New York agents probably have different styles of being agents. Do you see that? Do you feel like there's a learning curve there?
If anything, I think that Frederick will find it a lot easier because it's very complex to buy real estate in New York because co-op boards, lawyers, it's they don't even have an MLS system. I mean, essentially you have to go to every different company's website. So we have an MLS. We don't deal with the lawyers. We have no co-ops. I mean, it's pretty easy. Oh, and what about having to navigate through showings and not having to get an Ubers every 5 seconds?
You know, a lot of East Coast people, a lot of people in general are looking to move out of big cities after coronavirus. What kind of tips do you have for people listing their homes? What's the most important thing to know?
I don't think that I'm telling anybody anything different. It's if you want to sell your house, price it accurately. If you don't want to sell your house, price it stupidly. You can always do a price reduction like they say, but that's not always in your best interest. You kind of just want to price it right to begin with, get offers, and move on to the next.
Well, listen, I know that you are the number one Beverly Hills agent. You've had $2 billion in sales over the last 10 years. But let me ask you this, Josh. If you weren't a real estate agent, what would you be?
Architect or interior designer.
So still in the same field.
Yeah, for sure.
Well, Josh, it's been nice chatting with you today. Thanks for taking the time. You can catch Million Dollar Listing LA every Tuesday at 9 p.m. on Bravo. Josh, again, thanks so much.